In this lecture, we have to study about formation of typical spinal nerve. See, in the previous lecture, as I told you that TS of spinal cord is important for the understanding of the further part of this topic. So, in formation of typical spinal nerve, see this middle part of the diagram, this part of the diagram is the TS of spinal cord. Okay, so this TS of spinal cord, as you know, in the center, this central canal is visible. This is dorsal horn. Here also, this is dorsal horn. This is ventral horn on both the sides. And these are called as lateral horn. So, this central canal is surrounded by letter H-shaped gray matter. And gray matter is surrounded by white matter. These things we have studied before also. Now, under formation of typical spinal nerve, you should know that this dorsal horn, it continues as dorsal root. It aims into this dorsal root ganglion and again it continues as dorsal root only. Towards the lower side, this ventral horn, it continues as ventral root. This dorsal and ventral root join together and results in formation of this common structure which is called as typical spinal nerve. Here it is labeled as spinal nerve. This spinal nerve, it divides into three branches, ramus dorsalis, ramus ventralis and ramus communicans. Remember that word ramus is for the branch. Okay, so this is how the typical spinal nerve is get formed. We have studied before that spinal nerve is of mixed type. What's the meaning of mixed type? It consists of sensory nerve as well as consists of motor nerve. So, what is this condition? Remember that this dorsal root ganglion, it consists of sensory neurons. It consists of sensory neuron and the fibers from this sensory neuron, it moves in both the direction. That means here this sensory neuron is present. Here it's one of the fiber, it moves towards the gray matter and second part axon, it moves towards the typical spinal nerve. This motor neuron, it is present in ventral root. Cell body of the motor neuron is present in the gray matter and its axon, it moves towards the ventral root, towards the spinal nerve. So, in this region of spinal nerve, sensory as well as motor neuron both are present and hence it becomes the mixed type of nerve, which divides to form three branches, ramus dorsalis, ramus ventralis and ramus communicans. Remember that this ramus dorsalis, it is from skin and muscle to dorsal side. Ramus ventralis, as the diagram shows, it is the largest of these three branches. This is dorsalis, this is ventralis and this is communicans. So, this ventralis is largest of all and it supplies to the organ and muscles on the lateral and the anterior side. And third one is this ramus communicans. It is the smallest of these three and it gives rise from first thoracic to third lumbar vertebra. You should remember the position also from where it gives rise. From first thoracic to third lumbar vertebra or to the spinal nerve. And it joins with sympathetic ganglion here. This sympathetic ganglion is seen. So, this ramus communicans is joins with sympathetic ganglion, which is the part of autonomous nervous system. Okay, so what we have studied under formation of typical spinal nerve? This typical spinal nerve is formed by joining of two horns, dorsal root and ventral root. This dorsal root consists of sensory neuron and ventral root consists of motor neuron, which are get mixed here. Okay, this will be clear with the another diagram. See, this is a diagram for your understanding. Again, this central part is the TS of spinal cord and this spinal cord, it consists of this upper one as dorsal horn, continues as dorsal root, and this lower one is ventral horn, continues as ventral root. Here the mixed nerve, typical spinal nerve, is get formed. This dorsal root ganglion. This is the ganglion. The swelling is seen, which is called as dorsal root ganglion. Inside this, this is one of the neuron is present, which is called as sensory neuron. This sensory neuron gives rise a fiber towards the gray matter and another towards the spinal nerve. If you are going to see this ventral root, which is motor in nature, its cell body is present in the gray matter here, and this fiber it continues towards the spinal nerve. So this spinal nerve, it consists of sensory neuron as well as motor neuron. So it is of mixed type. Okay, so this spinal nerve is of mixed type, having sensory and motor neuron both. Later on, we have to study about reflex action. What is this reflex action? This reflex action means the sudden, we'll see first the diagram and then I'll explain this. This is a diagram for reflex action. Again, for the diagram of reflex action, you should know about the diagram of TS of spinal cord. For reflex action, for the reflex arc, diagram is not given in your textbook, but for understanding, you can see that here this is the TS of spinal cord. This is the dorsal root consisting of sensory neuron here. And this sensory neuron towards the outer side is attached to the receptor organ. This is ventral root consisting of motor neuron, and it is attached to this effector organ, which can be a skin or it can be a gland. In between this sensory neuron and motor neuron, here this neuron is present, which is called as association neuron. So how this reflex action, it works? Before that, we will see what's the meaning of reflex action. It is a sudden, spontaneous, automatic, involuntary response to the stimulus. It is involuntary response to the stimulus, which is very quick, which is very much fast. How it takes place? You should know the meaning of stimulus. Stimulus means any change in the surrounding. Any detectable change in the surrounding is called as stimulus. Here, the skin as a receptor organ is shown and pin prick is shown here. So this pin prick becomes the stimulus. That means skin is get a stimulus, that is pin prick is there, some abnormal thing is going on the skin. It is detected by sensory neuron here. These are the sensory neuron. Through sensory nerve fiber, through the sensory neuron, it goes to the spinal gray matter. This is the association neuron or adjuster neuron. It analyzes what happens. What happens? It is the pinprick. So what will be the response? Response will be remove the hand. So this response, which is produced by this adjuster neuron in the spinal gray matter, this response will be given to the motor neuron and it will be carried to the skeletal muscle so that our hand will be withdrawn. So this is one of the example of the reflex action, how it travels from receptor organ to the gray matter, and from gray matter it goes to the effector organ, which can be a skin, which can be the skeletal muscle, which can be a gland. So this path through which it moves, it is called as reflex arc. This which will becomes the reflex arc. In your textbook on page number 198, types of reflex action are given. There are two types of reflex action. First one is cranial reflexes and second one is spinal reflexes. Cranial reflexes, as the name suggests, will be carried out by brain. It is slow action response. Example, watering of mouth, sight of smell of good food, on sight of good food, etc. Spinal reflexes carried out through spinal cord. Urgency for response are required, so these are quick acting. Example, withdrawal of leg while stepping on something hot or pointed one. They are also classified into two more types, that is unconditional reflexes and conditional reflexes. Unconditional reflexes do not require any previous experience, that is sneezing, coughing, yawning, hiccuping, etc. And conditional reflexes requires previous experience, for example, swimming, dancing, cycling, etc. We cannot do this swimming, cycling and all without any previous experience. Again, one more classification is given for reflex action, which is simple monosynaptic and complex polysynaptic. When only sensory and motor neurons are involved, only one synapse gets formed, it will become monosynaptic. Complex polysynaptic reflexes involve sensory, internervous and motor neurons. Example, cycling, swimming. During cycling, many actions have to do at a time. We have to do many actions at a time. For example, we have to do the paddling at the same time. If somebody is there in front of me, we have to take some decisions, as well as we have to move the handle. All these things we have to do all together. So it comes under complex polysynaptic type of reflex action. Okay, so this is about, we have studied before CNS, then PNS, and the parts related with this PNS are the typical formation of typical spinal nerve and reflex action. Very much important part this one, because simple questions of 1 or 2 marks can be asked. Reflex action, its definition can be asked, its types can be asked. It may possible that examples are given and you have to identify what type of reflex action it is. So here we come to the end of peripheral nervous system also. In the next lecture, we are going to study about autonomous nervous system.